Our lead compound is a drug candidate called Bezisterim that blocks inflammation at just the right place in the right time. Right, so it blocks the production of TNF-α. So as a result of that, in our trials, it's shown that it can reduce inflammation and reverse insulin resistance.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Cuong Do. He is the CEO of BioVie. And Cuong, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Great to see you again, Steve. I'm doing great. Thanks for having
awesome.
Me back.
Good. I know there's been a lot of work that's been done this year through the company. We'll talk about that, specifically a couple of areas of keen interest. But for those not familiar, maybe give me a bit of background on the company.
BioVie is a biotech company that has two drugs in development. Our lead compound is a drug candidate called Bezisterim that blocks inflammation at just the right place in the right time. Right, so it blocks the production of TNF-α. So as a result of that, in our trials, it's shown that it can reduce inflammation and reverse insulin resistance. Parkinson's patients have seen improved muscle control. Alzheimer's patients have seen improved cognition, and everyone has seen a slowing of what's called the biological aging process, right? And our second drug candidate is BIV201 that's being developed for a rare late-stage liver disease condition known as ascites. There are no approved therapies for ascites, which is a condition that has over 50% mortality rate in just 12 months. And we believe BIV201 has the potential to become the first therapy for a terrible disease condition.
Okay, let's split them up and talk about them, both of them. In fact, let's begin with Parkinson's. I know that you've got a clinical trial going on. So explain to us what this trial is attempting to do.
Yes. Well, our prior trial used Bezisterim in combination with levodopa to help moderate to severe Parkinson's patients experience greater muscle control. So that establishes the first half of what we want to do in Parkinson's. We are now conducting a trial to establish the second half, which is to use Bezisterim alone with earlier Parkinson's patients who need to go onto therapy for the first time. So we are now enrolling 60 patients into a trial where half the patients will be given Bezisterim and then the other half will be given placebo. And what we're hoping to show is that Bezisterim alone can help these earlier Parkinson's patients delay the loss of muscle control, right? And that whole trial is hopefully will be fully enrolled by the end of this year. And thus, we expect top-line data readout in the April-May timeframe of next year, of 2026.
Yeah, there's a great need out there. I mean, what you're talking about here is affecting a number of people, not only in North America, but really all around the world.
Yeah, well, levodopa is a great drug. Right. Yeah. And it's been on the market for over 5 decades because nothing else has been better than levodopa. Right. We believe Bezisterim has the potential to be that first new therapy for Parkinson's patients since levodopa was introduced 5 decades ago. And we believe this has worldwide application. And in the U.S. alone, that could represent a $3 to $5 billion annual sales opportunity when it's fully launched.
OK, let's talk about the other drug that you talked about. Tell me about what's going on with that one.
Well, before we move on to BIV201, I'd like to spend a moment on just Bezisterim and long COVID. Within the last couple of years, researchers have tied the symptoms of malaise, brain fog, and extreme fatigue that's associated with long COVID to inflammation that works through exactly the same mechanism that Bezisterim affects. And that's why we've received a $13 million grant to go and explore whether Bezisterim could help alleviate these terrible conditions for long COVID patients, where frankly, there's nothing available right now. So we are now enrolling 200 patients into a trial that we hope to have fully enrolled by the end of February, which means we should have top line data readout by next summer.
Okay. And the other one?
And moving on to BIV201, we were in the middle of a phase two trial enrolling 30 patients, right? But we terminated the trial halfway through because we already had enough data to show that BIV201 helped patients reduce over 50% of their ascites fluid buildup. And we concluded that was the only ethical thing to do because this is a condition that has over 50% mortality rate. So we engaged the FDA in a conversation on what it would take to go to phase three and to get registration. And since we already have orphan and fast track designation, we only need one phase three trial to go in to get registered. And as of now, we have received all the feedback that we need from the FDA, all the authorizations that we need to proceed into phase three. So hopefully, we will be able to find the appropriate partner and funding in 2026 to allow us to start that trial.
Yeah, it sounds like there's a lot of momentum that has been built in 2025 that really is starting to get fruition in 2026, Kwong.
I think that's exactly right. 2026 will be a big catalyst year for us. And that's why I keep telling investors that we represent a terrific buying opportunity for investors who have a 12 to 18 month planning horizon, because we have plenty of cash to go throughout the year, right? And over the course of 2026, we expect to have two data readouts, right? Big catalysts for us, as well
Yeah.
as some of a potential study start in ascites.
It's going to be a busy one for sure, Kwong. Thanks so much for sharing some information, getting an update on the company and where you're at. And we look forward to continuing to follow your story, okay?
All right. Thank you, Steve, for having me back. Great to be here.
All right, there's Kwong Do, the CEO of BioVie.